Dear colleagues, my name is Anna Liadova. I am senior researcher at LUMEN of Moscow State University, the sociological department, the sub-department of the modern sociology. My report is devoted to the public trust and the major challenge to medicine as one of the emerging questions of modern society. The present study is aimed to discuss the trust modification of medicine in modern society and its causes. Trust as a subject of research has a long history. It has been regarded as the basis of human relations by many famous sociologists who researched the special role of trust as a regulator in social interconnections. Medicine is the social institute where the trust has always been regarded as a key element. The axiom that patients must trust their doctors has been as a keystone in the doctor-patient relationship. The maintained trust is one core guidance for physicians. Otherwise, the treatment that will be done will not succeed. For a long time period, trust was the fastening of the social contrast between society and physicians. According to its conditions, the medical corporation has been entrusted with the task of caring for health of its members by society, and in turn, the medical corporation has received special condition for their activity. The special professional status, prestige, internal control, and audit. Under this contract, the physicians were the main charge in division between sick and healthy. According to Parsons' sick role concept, only doctors permitted others to be sick or healthy and control society stability. Over last decades, they have been changed in the model structure and organization of medicine as a social institute and its interconnections to the society. Under the influence of change in modern society, the present paradigm of clinical medicine is replacing by evidence-based medicine. The high technologies implantation to the medical practice have caused two main trends. One is improving of disease treatment, more lifelong quality, complex diseases treatment that led to growing patients' expectations. But it has risen greater risks for them. Also, the high technology medicine means the state costs increasing that impacts reforming of national health systems by governments and find more cheaper ways for running them. Modern patient is not only a sick person, but well informed on his disease. Thanks to the internet, everybody can read on any diseases, put the diagnosis by himself, know about better ways of treatment and its possible risks. It alters the role of a physician who has been losing his unique position as a leader in treatment and makes him as a part of the complex organizational system. As a result, paternalistic model in the doctor-patient relationship that took place earlier has been changed over the last decade. And the base of the new model is not a trust but informed consent. Doctors now have to document many metrics, inputting data into electronic systems in order to meet requirements. The national healthcare systems are under the reform process. As a result, we can see erosion of trust in medicine. Also, it's difficult to measure, but the first signal of it is when patient stops coming to his doctor. It has great negative effects, such as refusing of doctor's prescriptions and the incompliant behavior. Doctor-patient relationship is damaged and turned into self-medication. According to the recent Russian Public Opinion Research Center report, for example, over 30% of Russians practice self-medicating. As it's shown by the next picture, self-medication is widespread practice not only in Russia, but also in Europe, USA, Latin America. But there are major problems related to self-medication. It causes serious health hazards such as adverse reactions, prolonged suffering, disease complications. As a tribute, self-medication is influenced by many factors such as education, family, society, law, availability of drugs, and exposure to advertisement. But in our opinion, the key factor of self-medication in modern society is erosion of trust in the healthcare system. Chase Chang, for example, a sociologist at the University of Hong Kong, notes, China's medical system is a market of distrust. The situation is similar in different countries. For example, the public trust in the medical profession has declined sharply in the United States. Only 30% of Russians trust the medicine as a social institute. Despite some difference between countries, there is a tendency of losing trust in medical professional as a whole. Anthony Giddens, who conceptualized the trust in modern society, defines its three types: basic, personal, institutional to the system, and general to the society. Trust in persons is always to some degree relevant to faith in systems. It means if you want to force trust to the system, we must increase personal confidence. So in our aspect, in the modern transforming society, under the conditions of the decomposition of its structure and transformation of hierarchical relationships into the linear network forms, special person trust to physicians comes again the leading place. Only such personal trust can be a guideline to potential future transformations, which needs a social movement's activities and powers. Thank you for your attention. We'll be appreciate your questions.